Hi everyone, Ravi this side. Welcome to Engineering Adda. So this is the third video of the Java 8 series. In the first video, we have discussed about the Java 8 features in brief. In the second video, we have discussed about one of the Java 8 features, which is Lambda expression, in a very detailed manner. In this video, we are going to discuss on the functional interfaces in Java 8. So first of all, we are going to discuss what is functional interface and what all the functional interfaces are already present in Java and what important functional interfaces introduced in Java 8 and how they are working. Everything we are going to discuss in this video through the practical implementation. So let's get started for that. So first of all, let me try to go to the functional interfaces slide and try to brief you about the functional interfaces. So let me try to go there. So, functional interface. So, what is functional interface? An interface that contains only one abstract method, or you can say single abstract method, is known as functional interface. But there is no restriction. You can have n number of default and static method inside a functional interface. There are a couple of already existing functional interfaces in Java, which are runnable, callable, comparable, and comparator. This runnable interface have only single abstract method called run. Similarly, callable interface has call and comparable have compare to, and comparator has compare. Let me try to go to the next slide and try to show you the other important functional interfaces that are introduced in Java 8. And we are also going to practically implement those. Okay. So when I'm going to create a application in IntelliJ, then I will try to show you or like walk you through this runnable, callable, comparator and comparable as well. And we'll show you the single abstract method of these interfaces. But as of now, let me try to go to the next slide and discuss about the important functional interfaces that were introduced in Java 8 and how they are behaving, what are they and how we can implement it. Everything we are going to discuss now. So let me try to go to the next slide. And first of all, we are going to discuss about the predicate. So these interfaces return a Boolean value based upon the evaluation of a condition. So predicate is also a functional interface which have a single abstract method. Its name is test and its return type is Boolean. Okay. So these interfaces return a Boolean value based on the evaluation of condition. Predicate takes an argument of type T and returns a Boolean result. So when it is saying that predicate takes an argument of type T, that means inside the predicate functional interface, we have one abstract method, which is test. It takes an argument and its return type is Boolean. In the last line, you can say it has a single abstract method Boolean. Its name is test and it takes T as a argument and returns the Boolean as a result. Okay, so let me try to summarize about the predicate. So predicate is a kind of functional interface having a single abstract method test. This test method takes T as an argument and returns the Boolean value. Okay, as simple as that. When we are going to create the application, we'll try to implement these things as well. Now let me try to go to the next slide and show you about the consumer. So this is a second important functional interface of Java 8. Its name is consumer. These interfaces accepts an input but does not produce any result. So this functional interface consumer has a single abstract method called accept. It takes T as an input and does not have any return type. So that is why we are telling that these interfaces accepts an input but don't produce any result. Okay, so the return type of this single abstract method accept is void. Consumer accept an argument of type T and performs an operation without returning any result. And here it has a single abstract method called accept. Its return type is void and it takes a argument as T. Okay, now let me try to go to the next slide. And the third one is supplier. This is also a functional interface introduced in Java 8. And It has a single abstract method get and its return type is t. It does not take any input as an argument. Okay, so these interfaces don't take any input but produce a result. Supplier produces a result of type t. It has a single abstract method get and its return type is t. Okay, now let me try to go to the next slide and discuss about the function. This is one of the most important functional interface of Java 8, which is function. The function interface is a part of Java util function package, which has been introduced since Java 8 to implement functional programming in Java. It represents a function which takes in one argument and produces a result. Hence, this functional interface takes in two generic, namely as follow. T denotes the type of input argument and R denotes the result type of the function. So this functional interface has a method apply, which is a single abstract method, and it takes T as argument and it has a return type R. Okay, so this is about the functional interfaces of Java 8. These are the four most important functional interfaces introduced in Java 8. We have discussed about their how they are working, what single abstract method they have, and what are their return type, what the argument they take. So briefly, we have discussed about these four functional interfaces. Now it's time to go to the IntelliJ and try to create an application, and then through practical implementation, we are going to discuss these functional interfaces. Okay, how we can like write or how we can implement the abstract method of this functional interfaces. Okay, so let's get started for that. Let me try to come out of this slide, and here we are in the IntelliJ. Now let me try to create one application here. So go to the file, new project, and let's say it is a functional interface. Like project name is functional interface in Java 8, something like that. And let me select the R type to quick start, create this application, open it in a new tab, and just wait for a few seconds to do the necessary configuration. Once it is done, then we can start doing the development. Okay, let me try to close this one and just wait for a few seconds. I will also walk you through the already existing functional interfaces like callable, runnable, comparator, comparable, and will show you how they are written and what are the single abstract method they have. So we'll see. I think it is good. Now go to the source, main, go to this application. Let me try to walk you through the runnable interface first. So just type runnable here, go inside it. And you can see this is an interface and it is a functional interface. So it is annotated with @ functional interface and it has a single abstract method which is run. Okay, so if you want to go to the callable, just put callable here and let me try to go inside this, and you can see this is also a functional interface. And it has a method call and its return type is v. Okay, so similarly you can also walk it through you can go through the comparator and comparable if you want me. Let me try to show you those things as well. So go to the app, let's say comparable, go inside it. You can say this is the interface and it will come up. It has one abstract method compare to. So if it has only single abstract method, it's not necessary to provide annotation called @ functional interface. Like if you want to create a functional interface, you have to be like it should be an interface, and then it should have only single abstract method in it. Either you are defining @ functional interface annotation at this class or at this interface or not, it is not necessary. But it is always necessary to have this interface only single abstract method. Okay, and there is no limitation on the default and the static method. So this is also a functional interface. It has a single abstract method compare to. Similarly, if you want to check for the comparator, let me try to go there. Like predicate, consumer, function, supplier. So all of those important functional interfaces we are going to discuss now. So one by one, we are going to discuss each functional interfaces. First of all, we'll see what are the methods inside these functional interfaces and how we can use them in a traditional way. And then through the lambda expression, how we can implement those methods, we are going to see. And then finally, we'll also discuss how those functional interfaces can be used in the Stream API. Okay, so let's get started for that. So first of all, let me try to go to the app. Like predicate, consumer, function, supplier. So all of those important functional interfaces we are going to discuss now. So one by one, we are going to discuss each functional interfaces. First of all, we'll see what are the methods inside these functional interfaces and how we can use them in a traditional way. And then through the lambda expression, how we can implement those methods, we are going to see. And then finally, we'll also discuss how those functional interfaces can be used in the Stream API. Okay, so let's get started for that. So first of all, let me try to go to the app and remove this and just create here a package called functional interface. Okay, and come into it. Let me try to create one class called, let's say we are going to start with the consumer. So consumer functional interface demo, something like that. It's a big name, but yeah, let it be. Now let me try to create this main method, and here let me try to walk you through the consumer first. Consumer functional interface. Okay, so consumer, let me try to remove this consumer. Yeah, if you'll go inside it, you will see that this is a functional interface and it has one method accept, and it is taking one argument t, but its return type is void. This is what we discussed, right? So now what we'll do, we'll try to implement this consumer interface in this class. And how we traditionally try to implement the interface in a class, that is what we are going to do here. So let me try to remove this and let me try to implement the consumer here. So consumer, and you have to provide one argument here. So let's say it is integer, and you have to override the single abstract method here. So just implement it and then we are good. Why we are getting the error? Let me try to see. Okay, so some Java related thing. Set language level to 8. I'm using Java 18 here and we have to set it to 8. Okay, so we are good now. So what we did, we have created one class, and we are traditionally, like how we try to implement a interface, we are doing the same thing here. Later on, we'll try to implement the single abstract method through the lambda expression. But as of now, we are traditionally, how traditionally we are implementing the interface, we are doing the same here. So what we did, we have created one class, we are implementing the consumer, and if you want to implement this consumer, you have to override the unimplemented method, which is single abstract method except. Okay, so now if you want to provide something here, let's say just want to print something. This is accept method. Let's say this is accept method of consumer. okay, and let's say its input argument is, let's say, integer. Okay, let me try to minimize this. So what we did, we have overridden this accept method and provided some implementation here. Now how traditionally we'll try to call this method, we are going to do the same. So just create a reference of this class and let's say let's go to new consumer. Sorry, new consumer functional interface, and with the help of functional interface demo, we are just going to call the accept method, and sorry, accept method which we have implemented downside. Okay, now you have to provide some value here, let's say 40, and just try to run this and then see. Okay, this toolkit target. Why we're getting this, just come over. Okay, let me try to remove this and run it again and then see. So here you can see we are getting the message like this is accept method of the consumer, its input argument is 40. So yeah, this is how traditionally we'll try to implement the interface and try to override the method, and then practically we can call that method. So this is what we are doing, but this is the traditional way. But when we are using a functional interface which are introduced in the Java 8, then there is a uses of lambda also, right? With the help of lambda expression, we can directly call this functional interfaces single abstract method. So that is what we are going to do now. Okay, so let me try to remove all this code and just let it be now here. Let me try to comment it out and just undo this implementation. And now what we have to do, with the help of lambda expression, we can directly call this accept method. So that is what we are going to do. So if you want to call this accept method, you have to first convert this method in a form of anonymous function. In the previous video, we have discussed what is anonymous function. Anonymous function is a function without any name and return type. So if you want to convert this accept method of the consumer, then you have to make it in the form of anonymous function. So just let me try to copy this and come here into the main, paste it out. Let me try to remove this comments and just remove this implementation as well. So now we have the accept method of the consumer. Now we need to convert this in the form of anonymous function. So we have to remove the name and its return types and its modifier. And you can also remove the type of the input. So just remove it. Let's say this time, either you can keep it as an integer or you can give any variable name. Let's say we are going to give the name as t. Okay. Now you have to introduce the lambda expression here, which is arrow sign, and then you have to provide the body of the lambda expression, which is open and close bracket. Now this is the lambda, and you have to provide the implementation of the accept method inside the body of the lambda. So let's say you want to print something here. So let's say this is the implementation of accept method of consumer. Okay, okay, let it be like this. Okay, and something like also you can say, and its input argument is t. Okay, so this is we have implemented. Now you have to assign this whole lambda expression to the reference of the consumer. So you have to create a reference of the consumer here. So just create a consumer equal to this, and you have to provide a colon here. Okay, so we are good now. So what we did, we took this single abstract method, we converted that single abstract method in the form of anonymous function, and then we applied the lambda expression there, and then we provided the implementation of the accept method inside the lambda body, and we are good now. Now with the help of consumer reference that we have created, we can directly call the accept method and pass the argument that you want to pass. So let's say this time we are passing the argument as 25. Okay, and now let me try to remove this piece of code, and now you can run it and then see. So here you can see this is the implementation of accept method of the consumer function, and its input argument is 25. So it's working fine, right? Through the traditional way also you can implement the consumer interface and implement its single abstract method and use it out, and through the lambda expression also you can minimize your code and implement it. Okay, now because this is this has only a single argument, you can remove this open and close parenthesis. Okay, and because this body has only single line, you can also remove this open and close bracket, and you can make this in a single line. So just come up like this, and if you run it, this will work good. Okay, you can see this, it is working fine, and the code is also reduced. But if you have more than one argument, you have to put this parenthesis, and if you have more than one line of code in the body, you have to put this open and close bracket in the body. Okay, so this is how you can implement the consumer accept method through the lambda expression. Now allow me to summarize the consumer for you. So consumer is a kind of functional interface introduced in Java 8. It has a single abstract method accept. Let me try to go to the accept and show you. So this accept is taking one argument t, and its return type is void, so it is not returning anything. Okay, so this accept method takes one single argument and its return type is void, that means it does not return anything. We have seen that through the traditional way and through the Java 8, through the lambda expression, we can directly implement this accept method. Okay, now I have a question in my mind, where we can use this consumer, or where we can use this accept method. So there's a use cases of this consumer in the stream APIs. That is what we are going to discuss next. Now let me try to create a list of integers and try to convert that list of integer in the form of a stream, and then with the help of for each, we are going to print list of the integers one by one. Okay, so that is what we are going to do here, and in the for each method we can directly pass the consumer in it. Okay, so I will also show you the use case of the consumer in the stream API there. So let me try to comment out this piece of code and then try to create a fresh list of integers. Let's say it is L, and let's say arrays dot as list, and let me pass some integer value here. Okay, now let me try to convert this is list into the form of a stream, and then with the help of for each we can print this element inside this list one by one. Okay, so if you'll come here to the for each, you can see this for each is taking consumer as argument, right? So let me try to go inside the for each first and show you. So if you'll go to the for each, you can see this for each is taking the consumer as argument, right? So what you can do is directly you can pass this consumer that you have created here in the for each. So let me try to uncomment this piece of code. And what we did here, we have implemented the accept method of the consumer and we have the reference consumer here. Okay, so directly you can pass this consumer to this for each method, and what it will do, it will try to print out each element one by one. Okay, so let me try to do it and then show you. So if you'll come here, you can see this is the first one which we are printing here when we are calling this consumer.accept method. Now after that, when we are converting this list in the form of a stream and then we are calling this for each method, and inside the for each method we are passing this consumer reference, then this is calling the accept method by itself and it is passing the elements from the list one by one. And that is why you are getting these things. This is the implementation of the accept method of the consumer function. Its input argument is one. You can see the second and the third, fourth and the fifth. So each element is being called one by one in this for each method with the help of this consumer. And this consumer is calling this accept method that we have implemented here. Okay. So this is the use case of the consumer. In the stream API, in the for each method, you can directly pass the consumer and then implement it. Okay. Now, if you want to, if you don't want to pass this consumer like this, what you can do, you can directly take this piece of code and then directly pass it here in the for each. Okay. And just remove this and then see. If you'll run it, you will find the same thing here, right? You're getting the result here. So this is about the consumer functional interface. What is consumer functional interface? We have discussed how to implement its single abstract method through the traditional way and through the lambda expression we have discussed. And then we have discussed the use case of the consumer in the stream API as well. So I'm not going to continue with the others functional interfaces. In a separate video, we'll go one by one and then discuss about the other functional interfaces. This video I'm going to end here. And if you like the video, please hit the like button and please subscribe the channel for more such content. And please share this video with your friends in need. Thanks for the support.